sponsored by the Big 98, Nashville's number one for new country and the home of a Bobby Bones Show.
Welcome to the Rock Interview. We're talking with Van Darien, singer, songwriter, guitarist, and her producer, Stephen Cooper. And you had a brand new album that came out in April, Levee. And I got to tell you, Van, I love the songs. I think my personal favorite is probably Ponderosa.
Thank you so much. Thank you for having us.
Yeah, you know, it's so much fun, you know, knowing about your music and everything else. And you grew up in Weatherford, Texas, and you've been here in Nashville since 2015. What made you move to Nashville when you really hadn't planned on it?
I mean, I've been writing a lot, and I knew that there were a lot of great songwriters up here. I met a lot of Texas songwriters once I moved up here, but it was really just mutual bandmates that were moving up here that made it kind of easy to make that decision.
Well, you know, and you started playing guitar pretty young and also writing poetry. So you've been doing this song crafting for a while, and it really amazed me with Levee in the depth of the lyrics and everything. And you had some pretty big name contributors too that you and Stephen worked with.
Absolutely. Yeah. Wrote some songs with Maren Morris and Mondo Signs and my good buddy, Joey Green. A lot of Texans on the record.
Nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, totally.
That is so much fun. You know, I saw some of the past videos, and I know that you guys were planning a big tour off this, but obviously with the social distancing and everything going on right now, are you going to be doing more virtual tours through your Facebook and website maybe?
Yeah, we've been doing some live stream shows. We're keeping it down to like one or two a week. Doing one with Gally Winter this week, and there'll be a bunch more coming up once this airs.
Awesome. Well, Stephen, I've got to ask you also, you know, being a guitarist myself, you know, you had a very unique sounds, you know, like particularly on Ponderosa, it almost sounded like the guitars were going through a Leslie. And then every song has its own distinct feeling throughout the whole album. I mean, you really did a great job with the mix and everything. I spent some a good amount of time with the album. What was your vision on this?
Man, you know, it was kind of track by track, but, you know, definitely trying to make the entire record cohesive, you know, with a lot of ambient sounds. So just track to track, you know, a lot of, like on Ponderosa, that Leslie, that was like a modulating reverb. I was doing that. But yeah, you know, we went through on the mix and ran a lot of the finished tracks out to like old Echoplex tape echoes and stuff.
I thought I recognized that.
Yes, a lot of that sound was coming from old tape, but just trying to make something that seemed a little more linear, you know, and start to finish.
Well, you know, and I think that's what I liked about the depth of the sound and everything. And also, you did the recordings at a studio here in Nashville, right?
We did. It was Glass Onion Studios with my buddy JD Tyner.
I'll tell you what, the whole sound of the album is very organic, definitely Americana. I can see where, you know, some songs could be considered more rock and roll, some more country, and obviously with the whole Americana umbrella. But the voice, I mean, your voice just really sings through on these, Van. And I think that the instrumental bed that Stephen provided, too, in the studio, it's a great sound. You know, you've had a lot of accolades coming in from Rolling Stone, Parade, Music Row. No pressure, right?
No pressure. I was really fortunate with those. I have a good team behind me, I guess.
Well, yeah, and also some great music and great videos, because I know recently you launched another video for Levee that came out on Diddy TV.
Yeah, we just launched it yesterday, American Steel.
And I wanted to bring this up, too, because I thought it was so interesting that your father had a metal shop, because it reminded me of my grandpa Ewing, who also had the same. And so you were around that a lot. And so when you were doing that song, it was kind of, you know, remembering your father and looking back at your time in Texas, right?
Totally. I mean, just being able to encapsulate that in a song and write a song with my dad that will be around long after we're gone while writing the same thing, you know, is kind of a special thing.
You know, and I think there's a unique depth to your lyrics and songs too, Van. Definitely a deep maturity. And you look at your influences, such as, you know, Guy Clark and Sheryl Crow and things like that. But you can hear the influence, but it's certainly yours. And what I really enjoyed about the whole album it's a unique sound. I don't think anybody else is really on the scene doing exactly what you're doing now, and I like that.
Cool. Well, thank you.
Well, I want to make sure for our viewers too, man, that we tell them where they can find, you know, your website, your social media, catch the virtual tours, and everything else that you and Stephen have been working on.
Sure. You can follow. We're on all of the social medias, Instagram, Twitter, Facebook. I had a TikTok started.
Nice.
You got to do what you got to do. It's silly.
They're spinning the sign on Galton, baby.
Whatever it takes, Stephen, right? You got to sell some albums and singles.
I got the gorilla costume. I got the wacky inflatable tube guy. I'll do it all.
What a great guy. I mean, see, that's a team player right there, man.
He's very entertaining. he wakes up entertaining. And you can visit my website. I keep it pretty updated, especially right now, just letting you know when shows are going to be happening and all of that.
Yeah, vandarien.com.
Yeah, Van Darien. If you're on any of the socials, it's just VANDARIEN.
You know, I love the artwork you guys did for the album cover, too, to where it almost has like a mini movie feel to it.
Well, the guy that shot the cover has made some movies. Yeah,
Curtis Wayne Millard.
Wow, yeah. See?
Did the Shovels and Rope movie was that last summer? Yeah, came out.
Yeah, awesome. Great guy. But yeah, a brilliant photographer. I play in a band called Indianola, and he's done a lot of the photos for us. And then, got Vanessa into a very cold Percy Priest for the album cover.
It was 40 degrees for that album cover, and I got all the way down to my shoulders.
Yeah, you're suffering for the art, right?
We all suffered that day.
Now, obviously, the album is now available everywhere, also with the singles. But if your fans and viewers want a signed copy, they can go to the website and possibly get that as well, and also maybe some Van Darien merch.
Yeah, absolutely. I'll sign anything you want. We've got some test pressings out there.
We got all sorts of swag, t-shirts, koozies, signed tour posters of the tour that currently is not happening.
Whatever you would like. It will be. And I hope that the gorilla costume also will make an appearance on the tour and possibly on more TikTok also, Stephen.
I think there's a there's definitely a resurgence of costume coming.
Well, I'll tell you what, I just want to congratulate you both. What an incredible album, and I want to make sure our viewers know, you know, go find the album, go find the singles. I say get the whole album because it's such an incredible mix of songs. You're going to also love Ponderosa, which is my favorite, but there's some great videos as well. It is Van Darien. Stephen Cooper, thank you also for joining us, and catch the virtual tours.
Yes.
And more fun stuff coming out this year too, right?
Yes.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for joining the Rock Interview.
Sponsored by the Big 98, Nashville's number one for new country and the home of a Bobby Bones Show.